Hello and welcome back. So yesterday we've done the first game of Stanley Parable. Yesterday we were a bit, let's say, confused about the game and what we were supposed to do. Just as a quick brief, we found out that we were a worker, that we were pushing the same buttons every single day, and then we went to discover the meaning of life. During the first try, we found out that there was like a mind control facility beneath our office, and we went to destroy it. And then we figured out a couple of other versions or endings throughout the game. After finishing up the game yesterday, I was a bit confused, so I went to the internet and tried to see what is the point of the game. And what we find out is that, in fact, the game does not have a real ending. You have 19 different endings, and the point of the game is to try to play and find different endings, crazy endings, normal endings, and so on. So let's try to do a second playthrough of the game today, and let's try to find the remaining endings. If I'm not mistaken, yesterday we've done 6 endings, more or less. So let's try to see how many other endings we can find. We're back to our office, and let us see, what can I click in here?
But Stanley simply couldn't handle the pressure. What if he had to make a decision? What if a crucial outcome fell under his responsibility? He had never been trained for that. No. This couldn't go any way except badly.
Okay.
The thing to do now, Stanley thought to himself, is to wait. Nothing will hurt me. Nothing will break me. In here, I can be happy.
I'll be happy
forever.
And happy.
I will be happy.
I think I just closed
Stanley
the door
waited.
And I'm
hours
like
passed.
Acting like
then
a 5-year-old
had years gone
which
by.
Is afraid of the dark
no
and, the monsters
tell.
Outside of the room.
But the
so
one
I just
thing
closed
he knew
the door
sure
and I'm
beyond
here
any
hidden.
Was that
and
if he waited
continued
long
to
enough,
work.
The answers would come.
Click, click.
Eventually, someday, they would arrive. Soon, very soon now, this will end. He will be spoken to. He will be told what to do. Now it's just a little bit closer. Now
here
it's
comes.
Even closer.
Here it comes.
Here it comes.
Okay. So I think we found out one of the endings by pure luck. Now the office is a bit strange. It's full of papers on the ground.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
What could it
Stanley
mean?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
So much paper in here. I don't think they know the meaning of recycle. Waiting input received, so cannot click anything else in here. Maybe in the other computers. Nope. Nope. Input received, but nothing is happening. Can I click on something? I cannot. So probably just a gimmick
Stanley
on the game.
Clicked on literally every single door in the office because he doesn't pick up well on cues from his environment. When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay, so we have here again the decision, left or right. I think that yesterday, the majority of the time, we went to the left side. So let's try to go to the right side.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew
and
it perfectly
see what
well.
Happens.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Ah, yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
Maybe like a drink? I want a Coke, please. Give me a Coke. No Cokes.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Okay, he's telling me to go to the first door on the left. Ooh, a light just appeared.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Let's see where this is going to lead us. I don't think that yesterday we've come down from this place.
He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now in order to get back, he needed to go,
from here it's,
left.
He was a bit confused about seeing left, so maybe there's another door in here. Nope. Okay, so
off. Oh no. No, it's to the right, my mistake.
So no left?
No,
right.
Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking? It's the
narrator.
Oh dear, would you hold on for a minute, please?
He's completely joking with me.
Now let's see. We went down right, left, down, left, right. Yep. Okay. Yes. I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way.
Definitely this way. Well, let us see where this is going to lead us. Oh.
No, this isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your eyes.
Okay. We just have to get back to,
Who am I kidding? It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable. How about, rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top.
Okay, so it just basically made me restart the game now.
All of his co-workers
this was
were
awkward.
Gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided
what
to go to the meeting
go there again?
Room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanley... Wait, what? No, I restarted. I swear, I definitely restarted the game over, completely fresh. Everything should be...
completely fresh.
Well, did something change? Stanley, did you change anything when we were back in that room with all the monitors? Did you move the story somewhere or a...
I swear I didn't do anything.
Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story. It was right here just a minute ago. I know for sure that it's here somewhere. Okay, then. It's an adventure.
Oh, no.
Come, Stanley. Let's find the story.
So many doors. And I don't know where to go. Let's just try. Where will this lead us?
I'll say it. This is the worst adventure I've ever been on. I can promise you there definitely was a story here before. Do we need to restart the game again?
No.
Well, I find it unlikely that we'll ever progress by starting over and over again. But it's got to be better than this.
Back to the start.
Okay, let's give it a shot. Why not?
Can you he's strange. He forced me to restart the
game.
All
of his co-workers were gone.
Why?
What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room.
Maybe
perhaps
if I
he had simply
had went
missed
a bit
memo.
Faster, maybe something different would have happened. Let us see. What happened?
Okay, yep, it's worse. I might be remembering this wrong. It's possible the story is back where we just came from. Why don't we go back the other direction and see if we missed anything?
Okay, so no doors now. And he's telling me to go back again. Well, let's amuse him. Let's go back. Username access. Let's go back.
Aha! I knew we'd miss something. The
this
story.
Was supposed
Here it comes.
Here it comes.
No, wait.
Nope.
Never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head
A
back
damn
the other way
narrator.
And retrace our steps.
Oh, come on. I'm back in the basement. I don't like the looks of this.
Now this... Well, I'll be honest. I don't recognize this place at all. Is this the story? I don't think so. I can't quite recall, but I believe my story took place in an office building. Is that correct? Do you remember, Stanley? Well, do you know what? Since I've completely forgotten what we were supposed to be doing, how about this? You win! Congratulations!
I win!
I know you put in a lot of hard work, and it really paid off, so good job. Oh, no. No, I don't feel right about this at all. We both know you didn't put in any actual work for that win. Some people win fair and square, and this was not one of those situations. Okay? I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time. I have to restart.
No. Not restart.
All right. Huh? I've got a solution. This time, to make sure we don't get lost, I've employed the help of the Stanley Parable Adventure Line. Just follow the line. How simple is that?
Huh? We have a line, and he's telling us to follow the line. What happens if I go to the other side?
No, no, I'm down. We're leaving it up to the line from now on.
Ah, okay, so he's forcing me to go where he wants to this time. So, let's try. Oh, solitary. So, room 437. Nope. Nothing in here. Nothing in here.
You see? The line knows where the story is. It's over in this direction. Onward, Stanley, to destiny. Though, here's a thought.
What kind of
Wouldn't
room
wherever
is this?
We end up be our destination, even if there's no story there? Or to put it another way, is the story of no destination still a story?
Won't open this
Simply
one.
By the act of moving forward, are we implying a journey such that a destination is inevitably conjured into being via the very manifestation of the nature of life itself? Okay, Stanley, I need to follow this train of thought for a minute. Just stick with me. Now, we can both agree that the nature of existence is in fact a byproduct of one's subjective experience of that existence, right? Okay, now if my experience of your existence rests inside of your subjective experience of this office, is this office in fact the skeleton of my own relative experiential mental subjective construct?
Whoa. Hang on. That got a bit weird back there. Well, I'd like to apologize. Not sure
Your
where I was going with all that.
You know what? I think what we need right now is a bit of music to lighten the mood.
Thank you.
goes through it.
Go back and look at that fern. Stanley, this fern will be very important later in the story. Make sure you study it closely and remember it carefully. You won't want to miss anything.
Personal files. I have something here where I can click. Consolidation reports, annual revenues, department accounts, financial, corporate balancing. There's nothing in here. So, let us try. Please put the music on. I was actually enjoying it.
Wait, what? We're back at the office? No, no, no. Line, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right? The story? Is any of this ringing a bell?
Okay, so I think it's the first time that I come in here.
Oh, no, back! Not again, Line, how could you have done this to us? And after we trusted you, after everything we've been through, you... Oh, I can't take this anymore, to hell with it. Restart.
Okay, so, this time... We're going to do it.
You know what, Stanley?
Ah, come on.
I say forget the adventure line. What's it ever done for us? We're intelligent people, right? Why can't we make up our own story? Something exciting, daring, mysterious. Ooh, this all sounds perfectly doable. Why don't we simply start wandering in, well, I don't know. How about this direction? Now. Yes, this is exciting. Just me and Stanley forging a new path, a new story. Well, it could be anything. What do you want our story to be?
Oh, come on.
Use your imagination. Whatever it might be, Stanley, I'm ready for it.
Okay, so I'm going around, and there should be a corridor in here. Getting confused.
Oh, no, not you again. Stanley, I'd also like to veto the lion from having any role in our awesome new story. No lions or monitor rooms. Just don't acknowledge it, and we should be fine.
The guy that was doing this painting is a bit crazy. Should have gone up now, but I can't. So let's move forward.
Ah, a choice. We get to make a decision. From here, the story is in our control. How important, we mustn't squander the opportunity. In fact, I believe I need a minute to think here. Just walk in circles for a minute. Okay, so I know that each door has to lead somewhere. Which means that somewhere, the place where we're trying to go, there must be a reverse door that leads here. And that, in turn, means that our destination corresponds with the counter-inverted reverse door's origin. So starting from the right, let us ask, will taking the right door lead us to where we're going? And since the answer is clearly yes, then by all accounts, the door on the right is the correct one. Another victory for logic.
Hooray to logic.
Our destiny
awaits. Let's get to the right
then.
The confusing ending.
Hold up, what's this? The confusion ending. You're telling
me... Deviate from intention?
That's what this is. It's all one giant ending.
First restart,
and we're supposed to restart
start.
The game, what, eight times? That's really how all this goes? It's all determined? So now, according to the schedule, I restart again. Then what? Am I just supposed to forget? Well, what if I don't want to forget?
If
my mind goes blank simply because it's written here on this thing.
Find a bookstore, get bored and leave.
Well, who consulted me? Why don't I get to decide? Why don't I get a say in all of this?
Is it really? Suddenly attempts to play the story, but
no,
is prevented.
It can't be. I don't want it to be. I don't want the game to keep restarting. I don't want to forget what's going on. I don't want to be trapped like this. I won't restart the game. I won't do it. I won't do it. I won't do it. And the timer stopped? Does that mean, did we do it? Did we break the cycle? The, whatever it is that made this schedule? How would we even know? Will someone come for us?
Okay.
Will something happen?
Let's just wait in here.
So, okay. I guess now we just wait. You know, I suppose in some way that this is a kind of story. Wouldn't you agree? I'm not quite sure if we're in the destination or the journey. Though they're always saying that life is about the journey and not the destination. So I hope that's where we are right now. We'll find out, won't we?
This one is actually confusing because...
Well, in the meantime...
Okay, the narrator just died on me?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Wow. Yes, this room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Do not jump.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
What happens if I
actually
jump?
I'm not your enemy, really.
No, but I want to go there.
I realize that investing in your trust in someone else can be difficult.
Let's try to go there.
But the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. What? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others?
Sorry, narrator.
Are you that convinced
danger
that I
everywhere.
Want something bad to happen to you? Why... I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance.
Nope.
Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Nope, sorry.
Aha, perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door. I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley walked through the red door.
The red door. Nope.
All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you.
Yes, I want to see what's in here.
You see? There's nothing here. I haven't even finished building this section of the map. Because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you?
Completely.
Do you not think I put a lot of time into that? Because I did. And
okay,
in the end,
so
it was all for nothing. Because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me. You've given me absolutely nothing so far.
I'll give you nothing.
Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback. There we go.
a third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
Okay. Although I would like to go again to this door, I'm compelled to go this. Let's see what happens.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here. Okay, so we're getting somewhere. Clearly there's something here that speaks to you. If I can be honest here, I really don't have any idea where I'm going with this. This whole third door thing was just a stab in the dark. But I guess you're into it, so let's keep this party train rolling. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
Okay. What the heck? Let's see what happens now.
Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors?
No.
Again, honest answers, please. Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely
Once
opportunity
again,
to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you? Perfect. Let me boot it up.
Oh, come on.
In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger.
Fuck.
You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game, all about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life. I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
No, please don't die. Okay, care. Bye-bye.
You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do.
It's
I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try. I'm out. I'm done. It's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable. Oh, hey, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just to ease the pain. Let's see. What do we have here? Yes. This seems like
Is
it'll
there
work.
Any door
Let's
in here?
Give it a shot.
But I can, no. Okay, so I think I've what
Well, Stanley, is this any better? At last, the one thing you've always desired. A game I had absolutely nothing to do with. But is it enough? Tell me that, Stanley. Will it ever be enough?
The Minecraft world.
I'm done making things for you. From now on, I will only create to fulfill a greater artistic purpose. Watch this, Stanley. I'm going to build a house. This will go here. No, here. And then... Let's see, what does it need? Yes, of course. And just to finish it all off... Yes.
Yes.
It's complete.
It's my house. I want to go in.
Look at it. Gaze upon my work of art and feel ashamed at your own inadequacy. Ah, but you've only seen it from the outside. You've only gotten half the experience. Please, step inside and make yourself comfortable. Isn't it grand?
I'm feeling so
perfect.
I'm feeling so comfortable now. My house.
Wait. That's it.
It's small,
we must rebuild it out of diamond. Diamond everything. Yes, yes, yes. Come along, Stanley. We have to go mining.
Let's go mining then. I feel I'm back to the World of Warcraft, trying to find a mining place. Oops. And I even have a music on for me. Okay. So, where to?
Oh my, it looks like it's going to get a bit dark. Have you brought a light?
Hmm. How do I go there? Because I see there's a door. I cannot.
Oh, no. This is far more open-ended than I had in mind. I'm looking for something more narrow and linear. Something that makes you feel utterly irrelevant. This won't do at all. 1 out of 5. Even the diamonds couldn't save this one. Okay, new game.
I was enjoying the Minecraft world.
Yes, I don't even know what this game is, but I love it. You, trapped in a glass box with no way out, listening to me talk. Oh, it's inspired. I couldn't have done it any better myself. What is this game even supposed to be? I can't figure it out. Okay, now I'm curious. Let's go find out what the hell this is.
I think I'm back to like a portal game.
Genius.
I want the radio to go with me.
No, actually, you know what? Mm-hmm. I think that's plenty.
No,
I really don't care much to see you stumble through any more of these games. And I highly doubt you're any wiser for the experience. Which is why, rather than continue to waste my time, I'm just going to leave you here. You can pretend you've beaten the game if it makes it any richer for you, but as for me, I've had enough. So, why don't you get cozy in this room, and if you have any grand revolutionary ideas for the perfect video game, you can just sit there and let it ball up inside you for all eternity. I don't need your advice. I don't need your ratings. And I certainly don't need the validation of a man whose job is to push buttons. I think I'll just go about my business, making meaningful cultural contributions to the world. And perhaps every now and then, I'll think back to a man named Stanley who was objectively wrong in every decision he ever made. The thought won't last long. Goodbye, Stanley.
Goodbye,
good luck with your
narrator.
Work.
Thank you.
And I sincerely hope that everyone lives happily ever after.
Me too. So, basically, the narrator left me. What can I do? I can jump. Or I can stay in here and try to see if the narrator tells me something. Although I have a feeling that the narrator will not tell me anything at all. Nothing to click. So I guess the only way is down. Well, let's amuse him. Work in progress, beta. The Stanley Parable Alpha Test. Work in progress. Filling cabinets, a work in progress. What's this? Oh shit. I felt, and I'm in an awkward place right now. I'm really in an awkward place. This is one kind of situation that if I was playing an horror game, I would be freaking dying right now, because this scares the shit hell out of me. I'm really almost shitting my pants off. And I'm lost. Oh, light in there. What's this? Buttons to push. I'm free. Mark cameras. How do I go there? Am I supposed to do anything in here? Maybe not. Let's go back then. Oh.
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps he's gotten it. Down in wherever he is right now. I wonder if he's happy with his choice.
Yes, I'm happy with
the heavy
choices.
Cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him.
Doing a guest narrator.
He needs me.
So I
someone
I
who
think
will wrap everything up at the end to make sense out of the
really
chaos
right
and the
now,
fear and
last
the confusion.
Time that I did it,
that's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end will be here soon. Very soon. I can wait.
You can wait, and I can also wait. Okay.
A soft wind blew outside, and perhaps rain started. And if it did, it stopped shortly after. Stanley hoped that he would one day see weather.
Well, at least the speech is different. And still, everything is closed. Huh.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
I'm sorry, but no.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. The lounge was sublime, a work of art. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nope, sorry.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
What happened if
I'm
I
not
go
your
there?
Enemy, really, I'm not.
Let's just try.
I realize, but in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death.
And plunged
good
to his
job,
death.
Stanley.
Thank
everyone
you.
Thinks you are very powerful.
Okay, so I just suicided. This is not fair. Because the last time that I fell from a big distance, I didn't die.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Huh?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Okay, this is a bit different. I could swear that it was to the right.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and yes, Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nope.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's some...
What? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why... I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance. Now listen carefully, this is important.
Okay, we're back Stanley to that walked point
through
where
the
I
red door.
Have the red door and the blue one. We went to the blue one the last time, but let's try.
Perhaps you misunderstood.
The blue one.
Stanley walked through the red door. I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley walked through the red door. Oh, thank God you are willing to listen to me. Do you see that I really have wanted you to be happy all this time? The problem is all these choices. The two of us always trying to get somewhere that isn't here. Running and running and running, just the way you're doing right now. Don't you see that it's killing us, Stanley? I want it to stop.
Didn't let it stop.
We would both be so much happier if we just stopped. And I think I have a solution. Here, let me show you.
So I don't have any other way that I can go, but this is so dark. Close the door. I don't want to go there. Let us go.
What do we want? What are we looking for?
There's a couple of lights in here. Okay, so this is the only place I can go right now.
Here. Yes. Oh, it's beautiful, isn't it?
It's beautiful.
If we just stay right here, right in this moment with this place, Stanley, I think I feel happy. I actually
it's
feel
so
happy.
What
no,
the heck?
Wait. Where are you going? Oh no. Stay away from those stairs. If you hurt yourself, if you die, the game will reset. We'll lose all of this. Please, no, Stanley, let me stay here. Don't take this from me.
Nope. So question now.
Please, Stanley, think about what you're doing.
Should I go back or suicide myself? Suicide.
No! Oh, thank God. No. No, no, what are you doing, Stanley? Please, I'm asking you not to take this away from me. I can't go back to what I was before. If you die, we'll both go back. Why are you doing this?
I'm sorry, narrator. Whee!
Stanley, let's go back to the other room. My God, is this really how much you dislike my game? That you'll throw yourself from this platform over and over to be rid of it?
Mm-hmm.
You are literally willing to kill yourself to keep me
from being happy.
Whee! Am I reading the situation correctly? Maybe you're just getting a kick out of it. I don't know anymore. I just wanted us to get along. But I guess that was too much to ask. It looks like you wanted to make a choice after all. Well, this one is yours.
Whee!
Is it over? It's going to restart, isn't it? I'm going back.
Well, achievement when... I've made the narrator really
all
really
of his
sad.
Co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Stanley felt lightheaded, butterflies in his stomach, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Will the narrator, like, prevent me from seeing the same exact
ending? Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
What? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others?
Yes, I do.
Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance. Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door. Aha, perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door. I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley, all right, fine, go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you. You see?
Okay, until
there's
now it's
here.
Exactly the same.
I haven't even finished building
this
section of the map, because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted? Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you? Do you not think I put a lot of time into that? Because I did. And in the end, it
maybe
was all
we'll
for
have
nothing.
The
because this is what you wanted
again.
To see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires
of
yours.
Get on
what would have
it.
Made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me. You've given me absolutely nothing so far. Tell you what. Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback. There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin. Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here. A one? I mean, I can understand if you had reservations, you saw ways the game could be improved to more fully express itself mechanically
but
and artistically,
one.
But a one?
Yes.
That's not even helpful. What am I supposed to do with that? But I guess it isn't my place to judge. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
Okay, so I went to the right side a while ago. What if we now go to the left one?
Now,
Would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors? Again, honest answers, please. Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you? Perfect. Let me boot it up.
And we're in back to game, killing babies.
The baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game, all about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life. I think the art world will really
get the
notice.
Popcorns.
But of course,
the,
message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours.
Burn,
so
baby,
why don't
burn.
You give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective?
Yeah.
Be
come
sure
on, come
to
on,
keep
come
notes
come
on your experience.
And bye-bye.
You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try. I'm out. I'm done. It's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable. Oh, hey, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just to ease the pain. Let's see.
What do we have here?
Yes. This seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot. Well, Stanley, is
and
this any
we're
better?
Back to the Minecraft.
At last, the one thing you've always
I've
desired.
Not
a game I had absolutely
to
nothing to
new
do
this
with.
Time.
But is it enough?
So,
tell
at least now we know that if we do go to that...
Well, I'll say this. I'm done making things for
let's
you.
Let's say to
from now on,
the
I will only create
always
to fulfill
end up
a
in the
artistic
world.
Purpose. Watch this, Stanley. I'm going to build a house. This will go here. No, here. And then...
Now the big question is, we saw like what,
does
five
it mean
enemies right now?
Yes, of course.
Yes,
and just to finish
enemies.
It all off.
So yesterday, like five or six.
It's complete. I made.
So we'll probably like
look at it
all through the
gaze upon my work of
enemies.
Art and feel
now, the real question
at your
is
own
how
inadequacy.
Can I find the remaining
but you've
enemies?
You've only seen it from the outside. You've only gotten half the experience.
Where
step
did
inside
I choose
and make yourself
a different thing?
Isn't it grand? Isn't it perfect?
Mm.
It could only be better if...
Here in
wait,
the Minecraft, I think
that's
that it was
we must
the
rebuild
thing.
It out of diamond.
There is no
diamond
other option, if
everything.
I remember correctly.
Yes,
we
yes, yes.
We have
come along, Stanley. We have to go mining.
Things. Well, let's try to hurry up this part.
Oh my, it looks like it's going to get a bit dark. Have you brought a light?
It's a bit, I can't go there. We can always try
oh,
to
no,
quickly.
No, this is far more open-ended than I had.
Because the last
mind.
Time.
I'm looking for something more narrow and linear.
We've done this.
Something that makes you feel utterly irrelevant. This won't do at all, 1 out of 5. Even the diamonds couldn't save this one. Okay, new
okay,
game.
So I'm at the end. So yeah, now I'm sure that there's absolutely nothing new in the Minecraft. And we're back to the
yes,
portal.
Yes, I don't even know what this game is, but I love it. You, trapped in a glass box with no way out, listening to me talk. Oh, it's inspired. I couldn't have done it any better myself. What is this game even supposed to be? I can't figure it out. Okay, now I'm curious. Let's go find out what the hell this is.
We have a countdown in here. Isn't there any way?
Puzzle. Critical thinking, Stanley. Your forte. Genius. No, actually, you know what? I think that's plenty.
I really don't care much to see you stumble.
Bye-bye.
Oh, wait. Right. So, the last time we went that place... Maybe there's something new in here. Okay, this is all a bit too dark. So I don't exactly know where to go. Let's try to go this place. Oh, and I'm falling. Okay, which means that if we arrive at that place, there is nothing else we can do. Maybe downstairs, in here, we have something new. Nothing to see in here. Yeah, the light. No, nothing, nothing, nothing. Still nothing in here.
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps he's gotten it. Down in wherever he is right now. I wonder if he's happy with his choice. And if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion.
That I would like to have at this point was like something like a checklist to know the amount of things that we've done and the ones that we're missing.
Once this ends, after it all comes to a close,
I know there's 19 different endings, but right now I just have a clue of what to do differently.
I can wait.
Yeah, game is going to restart again. Where to now?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Open, I want to go back. Let me open it. Okay, so... what can we do differently?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer. Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track. There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow, just an empty broom closet. No reason to still be here.
No reason to still be here, which means that I'll... staying here for a while.
It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet. He wasn't even doing anything. At least if there was something to interact with, he'd be justified in some way. As it is, he's literally just standing there doing sweet F.A.
Okay. So, I've seen here.
Are you really still in the broom closet? Standing around doing nothing? Why? Please offer me some explanation here. I'm genuinely confused.
I don't want to follow you anymore. I'll just stay in here and wait.
You do realize there's no choice or anything in here, right? If I'd said Stanley walked past the broom closet, at least you would have had a reason for exploring it to find out. But it didn't even occur to me, because literally, this closet is of absolutely no significance to the story whatsoever. I never would have thought to mention it. Maybe to you, this is somehow its own branching path. Maybe when you go talk about this with your friends, you'll say, "Oh, did you get the broom closet ending? The broom closet ending was my favorite."
Which was my favorite.
I hope your friends find this concerning. Stanley was fat and ugly and really, really stupid. He probably only got the job because of a family connection. That's how stupid he is. That or with drug money. Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and hookers.
Oh, yeah. Especially hookers.
Well, I've come to a very definite conclusion about what's going on right now. You're dead.
Really?
You got to this broom closet, explored it a bit, and were just about to leave because there's nothing here, when a physical malady of some sort shut down your central nervous system and you collapsed on the keyboard. Well, in a situation like this, the responsible thing is to alert someone nearby so as to ensure that your body is taken care of before it begins to decompose. Hello? Anyone who happens to be nearby? The person at this computer is dead. He or she has fallen prey to any number of your countless human physiological vulnerabilities. It's indicative of the long-term sustainability of your species. Please remove their corpse from the area and instruct another human to take their place at the computer, making sure they understand basic first-person video game mechanics and filling them in on the history of narrative tropes in video games, so that the irony and insightful commentary of this game is not lost on them. All right, when you've done that, just step out into the hallway.
Mm-mm. Okay, so maybe, just maybe, there's nothing in here actually.
Ah, second player, it's good to have you on board. I guarantee you too. Unbelievable. I'm at the mercy of an entire species of invalids. Perhaps there's a monkey nearby you can hand the controls to. A fish? Fungus? Look, you can hammer out the details. I'm not particularly picky. I'll just be waiting for when you're ready to pick up the story again.
Okay, so let us start and let us go in. Let us start. And let us go in again. Okay. Okay, so maybe there's nothing in here actually. I was enjoying this room. What do we have here in the way? Duct tape? Some tools, copper wire, a broom. Okay, I'll amuse you.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Upstairs to his office. I do not quite remember the choices that we've had in here. Oh no. Oh shit. I hate this one. This is one of those endings
but
that
Stanley
I truly hate.
But Stanley just couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss, admitting he had left his post during work hours. He might be fired for that.
Ah,
and in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk?
All because he believed everyone had vanished. His boss would think he was crazy. And then something occurred to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe I am crazy. All of my co-workers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment for no reason at all. None of it made any logical sense.
So I'm here sick
and as Stanley pondered
drink.
This, he began to make other strange observations. For exit. Example, here's why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down? Why did doors close automatically behind him wherever he went? And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar. Were they simply repeating? No, Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange. This can't be real. And at last, he came to the conclusion that had been on the tip of his tongue. He just hadn't found the words for it. I'm dreaming, he yelled. This is all a dream. Oh, what a relief Stanley felt to have finally found an answer, an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all. And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons. I may as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid. So, he imagined himself flying and began to gently float above the ground. Then he imagined himself soaring through space on a magical star field, and it too appeared. It was so much fun, and Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up. How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking? Now the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought. And while he thought it all very odd and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not
come
a dream.
Come on, narrator.
How could it be?
Get on with
was
it,
was Stanley
please.
Simply deceiving himself? Believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself? Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life. Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite a shock to Stanley.
There should be a way in this game that if you've already stopped yawning,
that this was in fact a dream.
Or you could skip
did the voice
it?
Not see him float or and make the magical stars just a moment ago?
The game would
how
just
else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too. Surely, surely, if he could just
because this is one of those endings,
he would prove it. He would prove that he was in control.
And
that this was a dream.
There's nothing new in here.
So he closed his eyes gently. And he invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin, the press of the mattress on his back, the fresh air of a world outside this one. Let me wake up, he thought to himself. I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over. Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing the buttons. Please, it's all I want. I want my apartment, and my wife, and my job. All I want is my life exactly the way it's always been. My life is normal. I am normal. Everything will be fine. I am okay.
Yes, 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 please get on with it. Yeah, I'm back in here. What a surprise.
Stanley began screaming.
Please, someone, wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who am I?
And everything went black. This is the story of a woman named Mariella. Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk. And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy. This much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like.
And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal. I am sane. I am in control of my mind. I know what is real and what isn't. It was comforting to think this, and in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day, the very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career, and by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this, so it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body. And then she turned and ran.
Bling. So, we're back to the office. And we're back to the office. Freling finally, damn it.
All of his co-workers were gone.
So we know that
what
we can't
mean?
Go
Stanley decided to go to the meeting
below.
Perhaps he had
stairs.
Simply missed a memo.
And I think that was the only possible decision that we
when
have.
When Stanley
on the
came
left.
To a set of
Let's
two open doors, he entered the door on his left. Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Okay,
coming
so
to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
The executive bathroom. Yeah, I don't think there's anything I can do in here, so care about this. Nothing to do. Oh. Why is there a guy killing a panda? What's your business strategy? Kill the panda. Okay. I honestly and truly love this music. Executive elevator, this shivers a lot. Really? So basically this is just shaking, but I'm still in the same floor. Maybe if I just press this button a couple of times, I'll get to a new place. Well, if I'm still on the same floor, I'll just try to click on it one more time, and if not, if nothing happens, I'll just move forwards. Well, in the meantime, let's relax and hear the music for 1 second. Now, close your eyes. Imagine you're in the beach, with a cocktail in your hand. You know what would freak us out right now? If something would appear on the other side of the door, like a big monster or something like that. That would scare the hell out of me. No. when I click this opens. But I'm definitely on the still on the same floor. Do you think I should just let the music end and see if there's something? Oh, okay, now it went up, not down. I'm pretty sure that when I clicked on it the first time, it wasn't. It went down, not up. So again, close your eyes. Hear the music. Imagine the beach, cocktail in your hand, the sea in front of you, and over 9,000 chicks dancing at this music. By the way, I missed the narrator. Narrator, where are you?
Okay, I think we all know the drill by now. Blah, blah, blah. Dark secrets, the keypad, Stanley pushes some buttons. Oh, hey, look, it's a new passageway. Kill surprise.
Can we click on anything here? I cannot click on the three. Yeah. Where to now? So, let us think a bit. Now we have the escape, and we have the mind control facility. The mind control facility, I think...
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read mind control facility.
But if we go to the escape room...
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death. The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Okay, so now let's go back. and see what the narrator says.
But of course, Stanley thought better of it and realized he simply had too much to live for.
Or nope. Not.
Still on board with death?
Mind control facility. I honestly think you've done everything in there. Well, at least now I know. I'm pretty sure we've done all the options if we go to the left door instead. And one more time. Isn't there like a button to run? Oh! If you click on the control button, you can actually crouch. Okay, this opens a new world of possibilities in here. Because, for example, I think it was on the Minecraft world where we actually had like a way below. Okay. And to jump, isn't there any way to jump? Only to crouch, okay. So if we go back in here and we press again the up button, nothing happens. So I think that the only possible solution is the mind control. Yeah.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out? Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Could help us find different endings? I think not.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly? No, he refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never!
Going to grab
it was unthinkable.
Some water.
Wasn't
be
it?
Back in 5 seconds.
Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
So, did the narrator said anything new this time? I guess not. We're still in here, so I guess not. Cannot jump.
But here was the proof. The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions. Happy, or sad, or content. Walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from this very place.
And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Nothing to do in here as well. There's a couple of buttons that I can press in here. Home? There's a door in here. Nothing to do in here as well, so... Okay, so I guess... Well...
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to... Oh, Stanley, you didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control?
Yes, of course I wanted to control.
Stanley,
to kill you, narrator.
I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go. Turn the controls off and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are set to explode, eliminating the entire complex. How long until detonation?
Where is the third button? I see the first, There's a force up there.
Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going. What all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? Mm-hmm. A moment of solace before you're obliterated? All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though, this version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not? These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons. No, these colored ones. Or maybe this big red button. Or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is?
Stanley, you're in for quite a disappointment. But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless, to see you made humble. This is not a challenge, it's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first.
Goodbye, employee 427.
Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here, just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life, or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice? Make it count, or don't. It's all the same to me, all a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we fade in until the moment I say, happily ever after.
But we did saw here a new possibility. When we press the on, that door was open.
Even now, Stanley's office was a distant memory. What did it look like? There was a computer, perhaps, and a painting. Was it a painting or a photo? He could no longer recall. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the
one
door
more
on his
time.
Left.
Now, the good thing about playing this game for a couple
Yet,
of hours
there was not
is
a
that
single
the number of
person
possibilities
here
is going
either.
Down
Feeling
and down
a wave
and down.
Of disbelief,
so,
Stanley look. Decided to go up to his boss's office. Hoping he might find coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. Here's the door, just go.
Quickly.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley
Please, if anyone who created the game is watching us,
to find out.
Please, for the love of God, if we've done the same thing more than once, please hurry up.
Now
with
the monitors
animations.
Jumped to life, their true
Please.
Nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing. This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly? No, he refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable. Wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof.
Okay, so
the heart of the
quickly.
Operation. Controls
we have
labeled
that
with emotions.
We're going to try
happy
to press the
or
on
sad,
button,
or
then
content,
run as fast
walking,
as possible
eating, working,
to that door.
All of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold
the
reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery wouldn't... Oh, Stanley, you didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control? Oh, Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story
yes,
off track, you're
going
to have to
please.
Do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent,
Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are said to explode, eliminating the entire complex.
Please, for
how long until detonation then?
Open the damn door.
2 minutes. Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated.
Oh, come on.
I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though. This version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not? These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh, dear me. What's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons, no, these colored ones, or maybe this big red button, or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is?
1 minute.
Do you really believe there's an answer? How many times will you replay this bit, looking desperately for a solution? 10? 100? 1,000?
Just opens and
I look forward to finding out and to watching the bomb go off each time you fail. Just you and me and the retching explosion of fire and metal over and over and over for all of eternity. And Stanley died again. And Stanley died again.
And Stanley died again.
And Stanley died again. Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here, just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life, or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice? Make it count, or don't. It's all the same to me, all a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we fade in until the moment I say, happily ever up.
So I probably did something different the last time because the door was open. Or maybe I was just dreaming.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
So any ideas where to go now?
Oh, and I guess this is where Stanley felt he needed to be right now, in this little hallway. Here, with no distractions, to study room 417. Not to actually enter it. No. That would be far too forward. Stanley wanted to know it from the outside, to see it not just with his eyes, but with his heart. He would know room 417 as no man or woman had ever known an office before. That ladder over there. Oh, and that little picture of a horizon or something. It's all just a never-ending parade of joy for Stanley.
Okay. So this is new on the narrator. Okay.
Ah, no, apparently not.
Okay,
when
so
Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Can I close the door? Nope. Plant? Can I do anything with it? Nope. Okay, so left or right? I don't think we have anything left to do on the left
this
side.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Let's try here on the right. Maybe there's something new.
The lounge was grand, majestic, perhaps too majestic, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
If I remember correctly, yesterday we've also done this.
But Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now, in order to get back, he needed to go,
Oh, no, right. This is that one where... Is it left?
Left.
Is it right? Not going to the left one.
Oh, yeah, no. Close. No, it's to the right. My mistake. No,
yeah, close.
No, not the right. Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking? It's clearly... Oh, dear, would you hold on for a minute, please? Now, let's see. We went down right, left, down, left, right. Yep. Okay, yes. I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way. No, this isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your eyes. Okay. We just have to get back to, Who am I kidding? It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable. How about, rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top.
Okay. And we're back here at the office. So, let us do a small break, because I need to check if there's any other ending. I need to recount the endings and check if there's something new. Talk to you guys later. Okay, bye-bye.